Hello, Jiu-Jitsu fans. Welcome to episode number 104 of This Week in BJJ. It has been a while since we put out an episode. That's because I was in Japan. And while I was there, I made an almost daily vlog. You can find 24 episodes on YouTube. It's not on the Budo Videos channel. It's on the Budo Jake channel. I showed a lot of different jiu-jitsu academies. I visited the world judo headquarters, the Kodokan, and had a challenge match. And lots of fun things. So if you haven't seen any of those episodes, please head over to the Budo Jake channel. But as for today's episode, we have an interview with one of the legends of jiu-jitsu, Joe Moreira, and a few new products to show. So let's start out with the new products. A couple months ago, Keishinyo came out with his instructional, the Barum Bolo Killer. Keishinyo is one of the best featherweight jiu-jitsu fighters in the world, and he showed a lot of excellent ways to beat the Barum Bolo. He showed ways to pass and how to re-Barum Bolo, how to stay safe from getting somebody even to get you in trouble from the Barum Bolo. He shows a lot of great things on this DVD. It's gotten a lot of good reviews, and now he's back with his second instructional, the 50-50 Killer. Now, a lot of people don't like the 50-50. It can be an annoying, stalling position. But Keishinyo shows not only how to get there and sweep if you want to get in the 50-50, but also how to pass and how to submit your opponent if you find yourself in the 50-50. So whether you love the position or you hate the position, this is a great way to learn what to do from there. And Keishinyo just took double gold at the Austin Open. So he beat everybody in his weight class and also in the absolute division. So congratulations, Keishinyo, on that. One more instructional to show today, and this is the old school smash pass from Joe Moreira. Now, we have an interview coming up in this episode with Joe, but if you are in SoCal, you know that Joe has a lot of high-level instructors. He's one of the first instructors to come from Brazil and teach guys and bring them up to a high level. So Joe is very well known in America and SoCal in particular, but he has a great understanding of judo and jiu-jitsu. And in this instructional, he shows you not just how to pass the guard, but he shows you a principled approach. These principles apply to any guard, whether it's closed guard, half guard, spider guard, any hybrid guard you can think of. By following Joe's principled way of passing the guard, you're going to have a game plan for whoever you face. So if you're looking for a good game plan for passing the guard, this is the instructional for you. And both of these instructionals are available not only on DVD, but also on demand on BudoVideos.com if you want to watch on your computer or laptop, or also as an app in the App Store. You can watch on your iPhone or your iPad. All right, now it's time for the interview with Joe Moreira. I've already said a bit about Joe, but he's an amazing guy. He's an eighth degree black belt, and he has answers for every position. He is an incredible instructor. So please enjoy the interview with Joe Moreira. Joe, thanks so much for coming on the show today. It's long overdue. I've known about you for so long, and I've trained with a lot of your students over the years, so a lot of things to talk about. But let's start at the beginning. When and where did you start jiu-jitsu?
I started long time ago. I have 5 years old. I started first with judo, but I need to wait for my brother. Soon finished the judo class. I need to wait for my brother to do jiu-jitsu. This is the next class after judo kids class. And I'm already there in the mat. With gi, with everything. No kids, Lara, believe me, maybe 6, 8 years old from myself. And this that time make a big difference. And everybody friends from my brother, everybody making fun of me. Beat me, smash me in the mat. And I'm excited from this way. And with my age 8, then my brother put me for kids' jiu-jitsu class.
And who would you say you learned most of your jiu-jitsu from?
I have two guys who make me good in the both ways. One in the fighting, the other one for be the instructor. First, I'm starting with Wilson Grace. he's in that time, you want to make the best instructor. He's cool, so clean, so different from the other ones that time. And I believe this with judo too, a lot of discipline, help make the view for the way the instructor supposed to be. My dad want to make me train hard, compete, and I'm keeping going training because I believe from my beginning, this is Master Francisco Mansur. This is my boat mank I have.
How would you compare or contrast the teaching styles of Francisco Mansur and Helson Gracie?
Not much different, because both ones come from the same school. My Francisco Mansur, he like fight, he like competition. And Helson Gracie, not much. He wanted to teach only for people with money. I believe he's done wrong. And make these guys more better person. This is about jiu-jitsu. Jiu-jitsu may make you better jump, make you a better man. And this is what he also want from his students. I have a lot of students coming there with a lot of problems, and his help with jiu-jitsu helping him be better. Francisco have the same deal, but his deal is more competition. He there, we do more self-defense, we do a lot of jiu-jitsu technique, but it's more self-defense, and one-on-one. And there in the Francisco Mansur, it's more group class, everybody training with everybody. It's more, you call it selva, right? Jungle.
And who gave you your black belt?
Both ones. One, he was giving me first with age 17, because I'm where he teaching his school for be the instructor. And 6 months later, Master Mansur gave my black belt for the competition. You wait to come 18 because he say, now you don't have the age yet. You want to give 18, then he can give it to me.
I see.
I really like fight, compete. I remember I'm 15, 6 years old. I train with a lot of men. A high belt and don't make it much different.
Right. Did you have any interaction with Helio or any of the other guys at that time?
Yeah.
What do you remember any interesting experiences?
I'm still having something. I still feel his hand in my neck. And the Helson Gracie. And this make part for my program too. That time you go change the belt, not because you're good, I drop the belt for you, you high belt now. Because you train hard, you do come every day, you make the deal for can be the high belt, then you'd be ready for can make your test, for can you feel comfortable when you tie your belt. He need to show me some techniques for each position and explain to me what you're doing. Because I need you understand you, I need to understand you understand what you're doing. Then make you more comfortable for making your technique. In some part, we do, I don't call MMA, this time there, you don't call MMA. You do more self-defense, street fight self-defense. But you can't forget you jiu-jitsu man. You need to use your jiu-jitsu technique. I do test for purple, but I'm young. He also give me, and the time I'm supposed to be, I'm heavy, 14 or 15 years old. And I fight that one part of the test. Both ones stand up, one guy with gloves. The guy don't use much jiu-jitsu, but the guy come for punch me. And I'm a jiu-jitsu man, I can't punch back, I can't kick back. I need block the guy we call stop the punch machine, bring the guy from underground, and then you only use your jiu-jitsu. The guy keep going, punch you. You need only finish with jiu-jitsu technique. But I'm a little kid, still kid, fighting one man, I think I have almost 30 years old, and I'm scared. I started to walk back. He come to me, I walk away from him. And Hélio Gracie, inside the room that day, then he give a slap in my neck. He say in Portuguese for me, jiu-jitsu man never walk back. You need to walk forward, you need to go to him. And this stay in my mind. Never go away. He all the time, come I push my students, you need to go forward. But the more close you be, more close you be in the area, the danger area, you have more chance for can block your opponent too. Mm-hmm. I go away, yeah, he don't go punch me, but I can't block you either.
Right.
I need to be in the position where you can punch me, for can I can block you too. And this stay in my mind, and this is my way, can do, doesn't matter for street fight, for MMA, for jiu-jitsu, you know, the top, you can't move away. It come forward and close the space. Then you feel more confident, less right. chance your opponent have for can hit you.
The early days of jiu-jitsu in Brazil, jiu-jitsu is much more closely related to street fighting than it is nowadays.
Yeah.
With the law and everything, and in America, there's just less opportunities to get in street fights. So I think it's a natural progression. But guys like yourself who studied early in Brazil, you went right into the UFC and fought. And it seemed like a very easy transition for you. Was that easy, or was it a scary experience?
In my case, I'm a gear guy. I'm in the mat all the time. I have many fight sport. But we train, the idea for the jiu-jitsu, because that time we have much competition in jiu-jitsu. But I'm a judo guy, so I compete a lot of judo competition too. This is different from the other guys who grew up with me and have much chance for compete jiu-jitsu. We do jiu-jitsu for self-defense. The gi technique is good for making your condition, for your reflex, for you think fast, for you be wary for situation the street fight. Because of this, I believe in the beginning, come not much people know about jiu-jitsu, make it more easy. In my case, come I fight in UFC for the first time, people already know a little bit about jiu-jitsu. If I don't know jiu-jitsu, but he know be danger to go for underground. When I fight one guy, 7 feet, 400 pounds, he only train for quem don't go for underground. And he's big guy, and something different for me. One time, I only train jiu-jitsu. I go beat from the ground, I go beat him. Yeah, if he come from the ground, but this time he don't come. In that part, he open a little bit my mind too. We need to train the old style too. Because sometimes if the guy don't go from the ground, you'll be dead there. And I did the exact way I did for my street fight. The guy big, but all the time I'm inside the area, boom, grab him. But I don't feel comfortable bringing him from the ground, have a problem with my knee. And he's big, that time, north, south, elbow, loud you can do. So I'm thinking about this everything. He don't go from the ground. And I move away, punch, come back again, and the fight go for this way. But that fight, I heard a lot. You need to train the old style. From that day, I'm starting to train stand up. I'm a jiu-jitsu man. If I do MMA again, I do this what happened almost 20 years ago. My stand up is much better from that day. But my deal is bring the guy from the ground. Because that one where I just train for all the time, where I mean, think, sleep, cheat, and jiu-jitsu. Don't make me more comfortable, be in the ground for him. Then I don't care the guy be too tall, too big, now be equal.
Right. Which, when you think back on your competition career, which match are you most happy about?
From that time I talk about me?
Yeah, your whole competition career, when you think back of all the victories you had, which one are you most proud of?
Of course, in judo, because I compete more and more judo. This is different from my fight second time. I have two win fight there in the UFC. Go for the final. Yeah, I can make the final because of my ex-wife calling me. Your son coming now. I bet he'll be here, so don't go change his name. And this is making me completely away from the fight. And the guy put me out anyway. I don't fight Mike, I want to go home anyway. Boom. But I have a chance for competing a lot of international judo competition. I have one in Japan. Before I compete, I live in Japan for 1 year. You have this competition there. And before you talk about Japanese judo, he's the man. Yeah, I'm so, my first fight, I'm so scared from the guy because the guy is Japanese. But soon I touch the guy, and my everything could work very easy with him, then just change my mind. Football. The only difference, my eyes can open more. And this, I believe, I remember this fight. This fight can make me understand. If you train, no have nothing different between one and the other one.
Mm-hmm. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and Judo both have the same roots, but the training methodologies are quite different. What do you think is better about the way Judo people train than Jiu-Jitsu?
Well, this talk about before, because now not much different.
Okay.
Before, he's more athlete. Mm-hmm. He trained hard all the time. Look like he people do rest. But now, this is young kids, he trained better or equal the same mm-hmm. for this Olympic kids show. The difference, we don't train much the way these guys train. Mm-hmm. And sometimes, a lot of jiu-jitsu men have a hard time for can finish the fight because the guys is in better condition, in better shape.
Yeah.
We, because of our martial arts, have very technique. Mm-hmm. So you don't need to push much yourself.
Right.
Different from judo. You need to train hard. If you lose the moment, the time, you're done.
Yeah.
In jiu-jitsu, no much.
How would you say your personal training has changed over the years as you've gotten older? How have you changed the way you train?
I come over here to U.S. I'm 28 years old. 28 at that time, you're done. You're very close for be master. In judo, for sure, you're done. I saw here. A lot of guys, 40, 45, good shape, training hard, and this opened my mind, I can't stop. And I believe from my 30 to 55, I'm 10 times more athlete. That time from the start, I started martial arts to my 30. Then I go for the mat training. The condition I have, I surf all day. I play soccer in the beach all day. This is my training condition. Weight, I don't like lift weight. I like to lift the body, but no weight. Mm. Over here, changed everything. I started to do more weight. I started understanding more the way for you can take, make it strong your body.
Would you say your technique is more efficient now than it was 10, 20 years ago?
No, the technique no change. The condition change. Mm-hmm. For sure, today, see, I be in Brazil, 55 years old. I don't know, I'm still on the mat. Mm-hmm. Here, I believe I still have more 30 years.